You don't supposed to be wearing none either. That's what's going down. They got you on lockdown. You don't supposed to be wearing drawers either. It's all a psychological thing. Your pussy supposed to breathe. Especially your balls. They're real hot. Why are they hot? Because that's the psychovertebrae. That's the home where the cooling heat is. And all the genital area. They got you all on lockdown. That's your chastity belt. So your wee-wee stopped working. That's because you got on them brief draws. And they put pork in them. And the ones in the fruit rooms, and they put pork in them shits. See, why the hell you think they so goddamn cheap?
How do you know that?
Huh?
Research,
been doing research, and people, you know, that's the spirit about being in the stuff over the years. You know, people bring you stuff, and there's all kinds of stuff, you know. So the research, they put pork in them. Yeah. But it's, you know, but that just makes common sense. You didn't wear that shit in Africa. You see, now, but, okay, so now this herbal V is good, too. Now, for the brothers that need, now, I'm going to give you two aspects. I'm going to give you one for the sexual aspect in a few minutes, too. But what I want you to get, the Herbal V, Smart Health USA, you can get it at GNC, and the women, they got a Lady V. Because what these things is, they enhance the Kundalini energy. And that is the energy that they're trying to stop now. The stuff that you're getting ready to deal with now ain't a fucking religion. And it doesn't comprise of you cutting up chicken heads to keep a bunch of other motherfuckers alive. It's about you enhancing the shit in your own body where you don't have the goddamn ass, you see what I'm saying, leg barring them to help you. You see what I'm saying? That's the old ring. That's on its way out. And most of that type of stuff, those things were not meant to be a religion like Christianity where you got mass millions of people doing these rituals and they saturate the ritual. That's why half that shit don't work no more, but you paying more fucking money. That shit been dead. But they got 3 million crackers doing the same shit. But it's supposed to be replaced. You got to use the energy in your body. And if your Kundalini energy is up, if it's up, then you can use this particular energy. And when you go around motherfucking people, you can use this particular energy. It will get you what you want just by your thought, because you're controlling shit. Now, so they got Lady V and they got Herbal V. Get those things. I'm telling you, you want to get on the God level. You see what I'm saying? So I'm not coming teaching you religion. I'm teaching you science. Go get this particular stuff. Now, I want you to take these not for sexual pleasure. I want you to take these particular ones to build the Kundalini energy up, which is sexual energy. Now, I want you to, if your wee-wee ain't working, I want you to get a hold of some shit called, it's this shit here is bad. It's called, they got it, it's coming out of Atlanta. It's called Stamina RX. Stamina RX. Now that's the one there, because after you take that about an hour later, it breaks down the capillaries in the penis, and your Johnson will rise. Your Johnson will rise. Now, the sisters, they got a Stamina RX for women, because what it does, it enhances the orgasm. And I know there's a young sister in their 20s like, this shit work. Because you want the orgasm to be enhanced because it's taking you to another level of spirituality. Why do you say that? I say, because it's all in the sexual magic thing. They got some sisters in Fayetteville, in North Carolina, in Greensboro, North Carolina. You'll see, well, I got a tape out, one of the sisters is opening for me, and they, at the point of orgasm, they be thinking, shit, this girl done got a whole house off of just all get masturbation and orgasm. Got a whole house. You don't even need a nigga for this shit. This is sex. This is the same shit that we, in so many words, look at as a lesser science. But white people are flying all over the world to Australia to learn this type of stuff. And this shit is coming straight out of ancient Kemet. The tantric thing that's coming in pre-dynastic Egypt and moved on up into doggone India. You see what I'm saying? Kama Sutra, Dr. John Mumford's book, The Art of Sexual Ecstasy. What's the name of that book? Dr. John Mumford's book, a black book. the dial of ecstasy through tantra is the name of it. Ecstasy through tantra. Get the book, Sexual Alchemy, Donald Tyson. Sexual Alchemy, Donald Tyson. Modern Sex Magic. Modern Sex Magic by Donald Michael Craig. Sexual Alchemy, Donald Tyson. Ecstasy Through Tantra, Dr. John Mumford. These are books. Tantra, the Cult of the Feminine. This is the feminine mistress. Tantra, the Cult of the Feminine by Andre Van Lysbeth. That's a hell of a book. Awesome book. Hardback. That's so y'all niggas don't buy. $30. $30 my book. Niggas act like they buy a damn house and get a book. Ecstasy Through Tantra. No, it's called Tantra, the Cult of the Feminine by Andre Van Lysbeth. That's a hell of a book. $30. You see what I'm saying? Now,
what's Tantra?
Tantra is the art of cultivating the sexual energy to produce the godhood and to use it as a magical aspect to do magic in the aspect of getting what you want and manipulating the forces of the physical. Of the spiritual. And for a man, if he learns how to use the tantric to prolong himself, he can get the goods and all, because a good man is hard to find, but a hard man is good to find. So, what's that?
Are you going to master those energies?
Any energy, you can master the energy with trying to learn how to reverse the polarities of ejaculation. Let me give you an example. This is some powerful stuff here.
Before you said that, the reason why I asked that question, I saw a special where there was a guy that was able to master the energy with his hand.
With his hand? Oh, yeah. That's he's using that chakra thing. Just there's chakras and stuff, and he did that to tell me to get the sister to get the orgasm.
Right.
Yeah. But let me explain something else on this particular science here. The sexual energy, we're trained that the sexual energy is the sexual act. When you get horny, that is the sexual energy. And with the man, when he comes, he gives all that away. So he actually loses the whole process. That's why you be mad at him. Bitch, I hash out. Before you fall asleep. But, you know, I don't want to see you because you done gave up your essence. You done lost everything. Now let me show you something about this thing here. If you got a woman, you be like, oh man, I've been with this motherfucker too long. I'm tired of him, man. She's turning on. Only thing you got to do is stop, try to reverse coming. See, when you reverse coming, what you do is you suck in her energy, because she is, all power is given to her. You suck in her energy, and when you suck in her energy, and now these sexual fluids, they you don't think, you think it is some water or some spit or some shit. No, it's some real powerful stuff. When you suck in her energy and you learn not to come, then what happens here is, and the first way to do it is start screwing until you're about to come, and then stop and pull back and just chill a minute and talk. Then do it over and over and stuff, and stuff, you know. But the object is not to come. Now, what happens is this here. You will pull in her energies, and then what will happen is this here. Your desire for her will increase because you still have her within you. Your desire, now her, she benefits because there's sexual energies. Kali, Shakti's, Gunas, Russas, Tamas, Ojas. These things is in Russas, it's in her, but they're dormant in her, and they need to get out when you give her the flow of the orgasm. You see, of the orgasm. Then there's another thing about her. See, a woman has mood swings, and you'll never be able to figure her out because she's more powerful than even she knows. She's a real primal monster. So what you got to do is learn how to stay long enough until the monster come out. Anybody ever had the monster come out in sex with a woman? The damn monster be come out of her. I mean, whatever she was in society, that shit is all gone. She done reached that goddamn point. Speaking in tongues. When the monster come out. When the monster come out, it overrides all of the pathologies and all the fucked up shit, and she become a new entity. You see? Now, you benefit because all of the fluids and all of the stuff that's produced in that act, you're gaining in. You see what I'm saying? So that's a part of that whole concept of what's actually going on. So that whole tantric process is some stuff that you want to also master and all. Also you want to master because those are gateways up in there, and that's why they want you, the black woman, shut down. It's bad. You see what I'm saying? It's bad. You see, that's the mystery on this particular science. Now going back, if there's a primal force that's in us, they know that with a certain amount of water, you might, in this particular cycle that's going on, you might give way to a new entity. And they don't want that. So they got to dehydrate you. Now, I did an experiment back in 95, the first of 95, January of 95. I did an experiment where I did 3 gallons of water a day from Sunday to Wednesday. I know some of y'all work, so I know y'all can't be doing that, no. But do it when sometime when y'all got some time off. Now, you know that water got to be something spiritual and got to be something good for you. You ever try to drink 2 glasses of water? Water will kill your ass. You want a bad feeling? Turn out some damn water. Oh, God. You know, other than being thirsty. You like to damn near kill yourself. So I drank 3 glasses of water for 4 days, Sunday through Wednesday.
Three gallons of water.
By Wednesday, I started time traveling. I went back to 1978. I went back to 1979, and then I started going back to 1955 and 50s and stuff. I wasn't born then. But my mother was there. We have her genetic, your parents' genetic memory bank. See what I'm saying? Genetic memory. So what had happened was, memory is more than just something in the past, because this is an illusion. This doesn't exist. You know, this is a series of events that don't exist. That's Maya. Anybody that's in metaphysics know that this is an illusion. That's why it don't matter what you do. See, right now, if you take your pathetic lives and reduce your pathetic lives down to nothing, that's called the body of no self. Now, I reached no self in October. Once I reach no self in October, that means it's over, man. You reach no self, which means that your existing self is destroyed. Now, like I said, one of the ways to do it also to destroy it is when you fall in love. And I talked about that, how you reduce the ego by giving in to the love. Let it beat you down. You know what I'm saying? And go with it for the ride. But you know, and turn it into a romantic adventure. And let it beat you down. So you, and you, what you do, you neutralize the ego. Because women egos is just as big as men's. Mm-hmm. Despite what they say. You, it's got to be. Look at all the vanity shit you got to put up with. Hey, you look good. Oh, my hair. I said you just look a good chin. Oh, my hair. Yeah, notice that shit every time you do it. You looking good, sister. Oh, my hair. Fuck, I just said you look good. So you know that, so what happens here is we heard here women say the male's ego. No, male have a different type of ego, and they have a different type of experience of ego. But women have massive egos, too. It's just we don't analyze her ego because it's all in another level. Look how jealous she get with other women. That bitch. That lets you know that she has the same ego. It's just that she has another set of problems, and we have not addressed her ego. But yet, the male ego has been under attack for the last 30 years. Now, rightfully so, with the white man and all his shit. But then again, on the other hand, it's almost like the women is just timid and just lovely. Because we need to ask this question here. And we've all figured it out here, too. Why is it when a woman is young, she likes a no good man? She does not like a nice brother when she's young. She might like a nice brother when she's older. See what I'm saying? So the concepts are we're talking about pathologies too. Too often that the brother ain't around when she get older. You see what I'm saying? But they don't like the nice ones when they're young. That's a reality. That's true. You see? And they know it. I don't like you too fucking nice. I don't like old sucker ass nigga. You see? Now, so we know that we've been in the whole feminist perspective and the feminine principle of the Afrocentric. We have displayed all of the pathology when it comes to the male's ego. But what it is what we don't understand. And both people have egos. It's just that her egos is another set of problems. And his ego is another set of problems. You see what I'm saying? And the whole concept is to neutralize the ego. You see what I'm saying? And how we do is we need to become more inward in feeling to neutralize our ego, where the system must become more intellectual. You see what I'm saying? The reason why I say that, man, we was in right before me and the brother here, we were down in Rodney, we were down in Atlanta in during the Olympics. Right during the Olympics. We was talking about all the current events. Whatever the current events was, we had equal men and women at this little barbecue. Soon as the brothers got on consciousness, all the women got up and went inside the damn house. You see what I'm saying? Because whatever it was going to another intellectual level, and they was programmed that was not a feminine thing. So they all got up and went inside the goddamn house. You see? So they say, you got to balance it out. You got to become more intellectual and analytical on that thing. And the brother has to become more, you know something fun? Go shopping with a goddamn woman to pick out some shit. That's some fun shit.
That's right.
And get rid of your things. No, I like that shit right there. Oh, that's some beautiful shit right there. You be like, well, damn. And then go buy some fuck. Go in the lipstick shit. So I like that color. I like that fingernail polish right there. And what it does is it puts you in a world. What this thing is actually doing is putting you in a world that you're not actually used to. So it's breaking up patterns.
Right.
That's what it's doing. It's breaking up the monotony. You see what I'm saying? It's breaking up the monotony of things. You see what I'm saying? So you have to. You have to reverse the gender roles, because this gender role, that's a whole other thing. You have to reverse the social roles. You see what I'm saying? You have to reverse the social roles and stuff like that. And that's what actually happens. You see, that's what actually happens and stuff. Especially shoe shopping, that's some good shit right there. You see what I'm saying? You know, I'm just saying things that you normally wouldn't do. Because we know the motherfuckers love some shoes now. You see what I'm saying? You know, love some shoes and stuff, you know. And all that's key. Especially and anyone and if you notice how you have a lot of creative women, all of them love shoes. You see what I'm saying? Real creative women, they be like, oh, I like them shoes. So go shoe shopping. So you're reversing these particular things. What you're doing here is you are dealing with the archetype of the collective unconsciousness, but you're reversing the polarities of what locks you in. That is what creativity is. You get where I'm coming from? That is where creativity is on this particular thing like this, you know. You see what I'm saying? So get the movie, like I tell the people, get the movie
Deja Vu. It's a movie called Deja Vu. 1998 with Vanessa Redgrave is in it, because the rest of all the other stars are unknown. 1998, Deja Vu. Get that movie, Warner Brothers. And all. Get that movie. It's a love story. But it's a bad motherfucking love story. It's the best. It's one of the baddest ones they put out. Now, don't get fucked up because black people ain't in it, because we don't produce shit. You know what I'm saying? We produce savage shit. That's Hollywood. Come on. And you fall for the shit. They make movies to talk down to you as an individual. That's just the way shit is. Why? Because your mind is not advanced enough to say, I ain't taking that bullshit no more. So you get all the bullshit. You see what I'm saying? Most of the movies produced with you is an attack on your character and an attack on your intellectual ability. You don't know it. Dumb, stupid shit. Like Comic View. You see what I'm saying? That kind of stuff there. Now, I ain't talking about the masses. Let them do it. I'm talking about you up in here. You shouldn't take subpar shit when they got movies with little children and shit be jammed up more than your shit. They got kid movies with white kids in it be hooked up. And they got children movies that you in. You see what I'm saying? And you sitting up here and all, and you going to pay some goddamn $8 to see some old dumb bullshit. And you prone to see these black movies because they program you to see this shit. And none of them are thought-provoking. You see what I'm saying? None of them are thought-provoking whatsoever. Now, I like Biker Boys because it presented something that you wasn't into before. And it's a historical thing. You got bike clubs all over the United States with black people in them. So they did a movie that historically chronicled black people in motorcycle clubs. So right there, it was something different. You see what I'm saying? It had, you know, whatever this thing able to take off of Fast and the Furious. You see what I'm saying? But I'm just trying to say, any damn thing other than the bullshit they give you on the norm. So get the movie Deja Vu. Go back and get the movie Somewhere in Time with Peter, with Christopher Reeve. It's a bad motherfucking movie. But that's some romantic shit also, too. But the complexity in it is hooked up. You see? Now, every woman I done got deja vu that look past the white people, you don't produce shit. Every woman, they like, oh, man, goddamn. Where did you get this movie from? You see what I'm saying? You're unbelievable. All the way down to the last little bit, deja vu. You got to follow this shit. You got to follow it. It's key. It's key. But you're going to reverse the polarities. Now, I want to do something. I want to take a couple of question and answers before we go back into some things, because I don't want some people to get out of here, and then we're going to go back into some stuff here and all in a few minutes and all, because I got a lot of stuff to cover, but we got 2 days. But anyway, because I need to go into some question and answers right quick, because I don't want some people to leave before we get some stuff that was on their mind. People had some stuff during the break. Well, give me some question and answers. What's that, brother? Yeah.
I go back to the male having to walk out.
Well, let me explain something to you also, too. Ejaculation is not orgasm. An orgasm is something different. Orgasm comes, start doing this here. Start breathing in and out real heavy, real fast when you're having sex. Like the women do. Look at her. She starts breathing real fast, and you'll find out that you can have an orgasm, and it's not an ejaculation. And you can have an orgasm while you have an ejaculation. It'll be something totally different because the energy is going up. It's going up. Orgasms is not ejaculation. An ejaculation is a lot loss of bodily fluids. An orgasm is something different. And as it builds and stuff, you see what I'm saying? You can go to another level. I'm going to the whole thing in a few minutes on what you need to do, because there is something. There is something that the sisters need to be getting into, especially if you're by yourself. If you got some sisters that's by themselves, there's a thing that you need to be getting into, and that's called a holy guardian angel. That's your secret lover that's ready to come and give you some ecstasy and shit, and you don't need a man to be with that shit. That's the last laugh on the cracker. You see what I'm saying? But you just can't be scared and shit. But anyway, so, you want to, if you get into the art of not having an ejaculation, sooner or later, over a year's time, you will reverse the polarities. An ejaculation will come a complete letdown. And because you're only trained to go for the ejaculation. Right, right. Then the sexual aspect will become the sexual act itself, and the feeling will become the enjoyment. Mm-hmm. You see? You know, will become the enjoyment. You see what I'm saying? You want to do that? Go to the sex store, the toy store. Get some desensitizers to start off with. You got a bunch of them desensitizers. The numb the head of the penis to start off with. You see what I'm saying? That's why you go all over New York, they got sexual stores in the white community, and ain't none in Harlem. Why is that?
There's a book called Sexual Energy and Yoga.
Yeah.
You familiar with that by Elizabeth Hyde?
Yeah.
It tells certain yoga practices you can do, like a headstand and a shoulder stand.
But the first thing you want to do is to jump start now, so you, because a lot of stuff it takes practice and win an accelerated age. Go to the sex store, y'all got them, and get some desensitizers, and you know, and stuff like that. Now, because what you want to do is you want to have sex without coming. You want to train this thing, no more than a month or two. If you do it. And you keep on, you reverse the polarities and stuff. Yeah. What's that, sister?
There's a book called Cultivating Male
Energy. Yeah.
And also The Dallas put out a book.
Yeah.
The guy Stephen Chow.
Yeah.
Puts out the book on the Dow, but he also puts out a separate book on the sexual energy. And they explain in detail how to ejaculate instead of ejaculate.
Yeah. All, just about all the tantric books deal with that. Now, there's a whole section. There's about 20, 30 books out. Or more on the tantric experience on how to do that and stuff like that. No, what's that?
Yeah, like many of the myths that I've studied have always depicted men like before, like sexual intercourse, holding one hand and the hieroglyphics, holding one hand to the head and holding one hand around the phallus or the penis.
Uh-huh.
And the thing is, I was always trying to figure out, like, people talk about the mind state during conception. Determining like the outlook of like you ever notice how you got like two parents that are pretty like balanced individuals, but they had their child as like a spawn from hell. You know, it's like the mind state during sexual activity can determine the outlook of that child. You know,
well, the mystery of sex is so vast; it's like a whole nother ecology, yeah. And all of that stuff play. There's another book that give you the vast gamut on it. It's like they took everything they could find on and put in one book called Sexual Secrets. It's a big book. That one gives you all the stuff. Some books deal with certain practices. This one here gives you all of that, not only that, the philosophy behind it. But I'm telling you, one of the baddest ones on the planet now is Van Lysbeth's book, Tantra, the Cult of the Feminine. Because that one talks about how whenever she gets to that ninth gate, that was the movie, that was the fucking movie was about. When he got to that ninth gate, she got on his dick and rode it. And that was the ninth gate. Another motherfucker burned himself up with some damn pictures, and he didn't understand. He needed to get on the damn shit and fuck this, you know, get this woman to damn jack him up and ride his shit the college style. But the ninth gate, when they say she hits that ninth gate, there's a light that comes around her, and both people are engulfed in the light and stuff. And you go to a whole nother Godhead or God form and stuff like that. But that's the cult of the feminine. But there's another book called Sexual Secrets, and they give you all this shit. You see, they give you it's just a mirage and just a collage of all this sexual stuff. The Sexual Secrets book and all. That's a good one. Yeah, what's that?
Is there a short step to activate and balance? Chakras, if you have a problem activating, raising the kundalini?
You don't need to balance the chakras. The kundalini basically is the path of the chakras. The chakras are connected with the kundalini. If you raise the kundalini, you understand what I'm saying? You could do that. Now, I'm going to tell you, there's a good tape out.
You never get out of line, like maybe one is.
That must be for some white people, because I really don't aspire to that shit, you know, all in line. You know, that's them in the balancing of the chakras. Like C. Primanel, you said, the damn chakras know what they are. They're intelligence. It's the kundalini energy. Your shit is already balanced. You see, a lot of that stuff, there's the technicality that's in the New Age and a lot of white folks did and stuff like that. But let me, so you can get real technical about it, and really you ain't really doing a waste of time. You really wasting time. A lot of the shit you can do with your, you can do with your mind. But I'm going to tell you one good tape. If you can get a tape called The Sounds of the Chakras, put out by Destiny Books, but it's an audio cassette. And it might be on CD now. The Sounds of the Chakras. You can get a hold of that, and that's a bad one, because you go on each pedal, and you do these mantras, ling, ying, ting. You go all the way up to, they tell you what to do, and you go all the way up the scale. When you get to the scale, you be high as shit. You see what I'm saying? You be high as stuff. Also, too, what happened was, is when I started time traveling with the water, I want to put this in there, too. I got to the point where I could drink 2 glasses of water and be fucked up like I drank a damn old English 800. Be drunk as shit. Why? Because the properties and all the stuff that's in the universe and all the stuff that's in minerals and all that stuff is inside your body. And when you're drinking up water, you loosen up that shit and you get a high. I have been drunk as shit off water. Water therapy. You can heal most of the things with water. Most of the things with water. And also, Dick Gregory come, they come new research saying that high blood pressure, the stuff that they talk about is not based on sodium. It's based on mercury in the body. No, lead. Lead in the body. That's the new research. Lead. They say lead is so powerful you can kill, you can shoot your grandfather and the lead can get in his DNA and affect his children. And the only way to get the lead out, they say when they dropped a bomb on Hiroshima, they had white people go come from, scientists come from all over the world to study this shit. The effects of what that nuclear blast did. And they was finding out that the people was not in bad shape as they thought they were. Why? Because number one, they were still much more indigenous than white folks. And they found out that the water streams wasn't even contaminated, but they found out that they had the algae going around and seaweed growing along the water. And basically, what gets rid of lead is kelp. Take 3 kelp. You can take the kelp pills in the morning, 3 kelps in the morning, 3 in the afternoon, and it washes the lead out your body. They can control the high blood pressure shit they talking about, if there's any negative things also, too. But get The Sounds of the Chakras is one of the tapes. If you can find it, by Destiny Books. It might be on a cassette right now. Give me some more questions.
You got it. I'm just making a mistake. Did you have a movie called Dreamcatcher coming out?
Oh, yeah. It's basically
the Wachowski brothers, the guys that made The Matrix.
Yeah.
They have a 9-minute animated short coming out right before that movie called The Last Flight of Osiris, just in case anybody didn't know.
Oh, okay, yeah. But before the Dreamcatchers?
Yeah.
Yeah, also there's a movie, there's several good movies out, there's another one, I know Dreamcatchers, get the movie Waking Life. It's a movie that they shot a movie and they went in and animated it over the real flicks. But it's Waking Life and it's talking about all this, how this is being an illusion. So it piggybacks off of the whole Matrix thing. It's called Waking Life. And all, and it deals with some stuff where there's one person says the biggest mistake a person makes is to think that one is actually alive when you're only asleep in life's waiting room. You're not even alive. That's what Krishnamurti and all the other doggone ancient masters saying, man, I can't wait till I wake up. And you know Krishnamurti was Bruce Lee's. When he really got into his spiritual stuff, was he studied Krishnamurti. You see what I'm saying? And he said, be water, my friend. They're going to water again. You see what I'm saying? So we're not even alive. That's why I say your pathetic life don't matter. So that means religion is false. To tell you that your behavior down here has something to do. And it ain't even good behavior in the aspect of something spiritual you're doing. They just talk about all them little Ten Commandments bullshit, you can break all them shits. Don't make a damn bit of difference. The white man, if he ain't ever taught you nothing, he taught you that shit. Even the karma shit that we done got into is nothing but a later day form of sin and religion. None of that shit happens because the earlier texts don't even deal with that in India. So the whole karma thing is bullshit.
So you don't believe that when you put out your receipt?
No. Let's put it this way. Let me explain something about the negative confession and the Egyptian thing. I be fucking niggas up on this all across the goddamn country. When we learned about that, you know, I have not done this and I have not done that. We learned that from historians, and they were only comparing it to the Ten Commandments. If you go down to, how many is it?
42.
It's 42 negative confessions, but they say it's like 100 and something. 147, right? If you go down 147 things that you are not to do, you wouldn't even be able to live life. That means you just need to stand still like this because you couldn't do shit. There's a great mystery to this shit. The great mystery here is that when he's reciting the negative confession, and he said, I have not done this, I have not done that, naturally your physical body, you're capable of doing anything just to survive.
Right.
It's not him in the physical form that have not done these things. It is his soul that is on the inside of him that has not done these things, because your soul is sleep. You ever heard of the sleeping Buddha? So ultimately, when you really think about ultimately, it don't give a fuck what you do. Let me give you something. Look at this. Now this is Egyptian thought. Look at this. The physical man has been instructed of psychic matters, and they understand by works and mere faith that they do not have perfect knowledge. They belong to the earthly church. Good conduct is necessary for them, for otherwise they could not be saved. And I'll tell you in a few minutes. But we spirituals shall certainly be saved not by conduct, but because we by nature are spiritual. It ain't got shit to do with what you do down here. Just as the earthly man cannot participate in salvation, for it is not capable of receiving it. What do they mean by that? Now, this is a dialogue between the soul and the physical body. One, they're saying that the earthly man, which is your physical body, you need good conduct because that's just a moral code and a political way that you survive in society. You don't want to kill up everybody. You don't want to walk in the goddamn street blindfold. You might get hit by a truck. You see? We spirituals is your soul. It says, but we spirituals shall be saved not by conduct, but simply because by nature we are spiritual. That's your soul talking. Now look at this. Just as earthly conduct is, just as the earthly cannot participate in salvation because it is not capable of it. The physical body cannot go beyond the physical realm. It dies. Hold on, back up. Just listen, you gotta listen. Don't think of your goddamn rebuttal until I listen to what I'm saying. You got to look in your head. Here's the soul, here's the spirit. Here's the soul, here's the spirit. They are two different worlds. They have nothing to do with each other. Nothing whatsoever. Because guess what? The soul is asleep. That's called a sleeping Buddha. The soul is asleep. The soul only wakes up when you become illuminated. The soul is not even here. It's dormant. It's down in your gastrointestinal tract, up under the ravenous dragon, the shit sack. The shit sack, the dookie shoe, the intestines. Now, wait a minute now, listen. Now, what's happening here is you got two things going on. Now, you got to listen. Now, this is pharaonic thought. You see what I'm saying? This ain't going to look at some statues and some pyramids and stepping off on another foot and reading some bullshit Book of the Dead, which is a pathetic book. Why? Because it was a book for the priesthood. And it was stupid to think that we're going to put that up with, like, the Bible, because the Egyptians didn't have one major book. They had libraries and volumes of book. And probably that's insignificant. That's why you ain't never been able to do nothing with a piece of shit. It's a rag. significant in a time when the goddamn priesthood was what they were doing. But here it is again. We got to be like the Christian. We got to find the sacred book in Egypt. So we look at that book and just thought that book was the holy book, like the Bible. And it wasn't. That's why you ain't benefited from the bullshit since it was around. Look. Check this shit out. Now, good conduct is necessary for the earthly. Otherwise, they cannot be saved. That's your physical body. And they're not talking about conduct of you being saved on the spiritual realm. They're talking about surviving in a physical world. Don't hit that end of that table, man. You're going to hurt your goddamn knee. See what I'm saying? Get you some soft toilet tissue so you don't have no chafe on the booty hole. Now, for otherwise, what I am doing when I get raunchy like this, because I know that even we Afrocentric people, oh, peace and love. Oh, we done turned into old punkified, all that old bullshit. We done traded some shit. All the Afrocentric motherfuckers are the worst. Oh, peace and love, brother. Hugging this old nasty motherfucker. I don't use deodorant. Goddamn it, motherfucker, you stink. Them goddamn oils don't do it. Tired of the motherfucking damn Afrocentric motherfuckers. I've been a part of that shit for 12 years. Motherfucker, get some goddamn deodorant. Not talking about you, stink ass motherfucker. I don't use deodorant. Get some goddamn right guard, motherfucker. Left guard, left tackle. Get some Mitchum. That's the strongest shit on the planet. Goddamn Mitchum. Hold on, man. Hold on. Now check it out. Check it out. That's why I talk, bust up all that old bullshit. Because the Osirian energy is the Dionysian, and it's about creativity through demolishing the laws of the physical. It's called the return of the repressed. What repressed you? Society and taboos. The Africans got 1,000 of them. You see what I'm saying? So now, come on. Now look, check it out. But we spirituals can certainly be saved because by nature we are spiritual. Just as the earthly cannot participate in salvation because it's not capable of it. This physical is not capable of it. So in turn, the spiritual cannot accept decay, no matter what action it undertakes. Just as gold placed in the mud does not lose the shape of the gold, but the beauty retains its own nature, and the mud cannot harm the gold. So we cannot damage or lose our spiritual nature, even if we engage in various natural actions.
I completely agree with that, but through my own spiritual experiences, I communicate with many souls that have become entrapped in this community.
Look here.
So I'm trying to see what your view is.
Okay, I'm a silent seat because you spiritual motherfucker, you messing with the master. God damn it, I done been there. Them souls is trapped and shit because those souls are trapped because those souls are trapped because we are in the physical, period. The fall of man is coming into a physical body. You see what I'm saying? Those souls are trapped because most souls are ignorant. And because you leave the physical body, if you was a Willie Washington, a fucked up nigga in Alabama, you're going to be a fucked up nigga in the spirit world. You're fucking with me. Motherfucker, you can't tell me nothing about the spirit world because I live this shit. Yeah. You communicate, I communicate. You messing with the goddamn master with this shit here. I know what I'm talking about. The whole aspect of that type of thing, and it's not based on no good behavior. It's based on we fell from a lofty height because our grandchildren put us here. Fucking roaring them motherfucking asshole bastards. The demiurge. Do you know the stories of these things?
No.
I'll get to it in a few minutes. It ain't got nothing to do with no behavior. Do you think good behavior? You know how many goddamn souls you would have to damn train? This is ludicrous. You know how many damn souls you would have to damn work with to get those souls to go to another level? We'll be here another million years. It's impossible. So this thing does not come down to what you physically behave. It comes down to Those souls are bouncing around in different various incarnations until that cycle that holds this matrix together is worn out. And that's where we are now. It has nothing to do with we're going to take a manifesto and we're going to get the souls. What? We're going to get the souls to rise up.
You just said, though, if you live a fucked up life, you got a fucked up afterlife.
No. What I'm trying to say here is this. Try to understand. What I'm trying to tell you, if you take the highest soul that you're talking about, that soul is fucked up. For the mere fact that we're still in an illusionary world and we have different worlds. So what I'm trying to tell you, let me give you an example. What path do you deal with?
I deal with everything.
Yeah, okay, but this is one path a lot of people make mistakes on. Is the yogi shit. And this is what's going on here. This is very good. I'm not challenging you. I'm not trying to speak down to you. This is just, I'm very passionate, like the little white girl said on this show. Let me show you about this. Check this out. You meditate? Okay. Meditation gets you on the astral plane. And there's various levels of those dimensions of those planes. Those planes. It's all called the Devashanic plane, which is the top plane. The Buddhic plane, the Etheric plane, all these damn planes. Guess what? This is the earth, and it just represents the physical matrix of Maya and illusion. Guess what? When your soul climbs all these planes, guess what? You're still in the matrix. The entire universe is the matrix and has to be destroyed. So the whole concept of a yogi raising themselves up is ludicrous. That's a form of religion. I'm going to tell you what I mean by that. In the ancient texts, Shiva has to come back to destroy the universe and the gods. So if the universe was a perfect place that you could raise yourself up in, why does Shiva have to come back and destroy the universe and the gods? Why does Horus got to come back and destroy the universe and the gods? You see what I'm saying? Why does Hercules have to come back and destroy the universe and the gods? You see what I'm saying? So my point here is, we knew that we had thousands of years to be here, and you could raise yourself up to those levels of existence, and that's what the Egyptians was doing, but there were still levels of the existing world called the world of formation. Our world exists after several primal worlds that existed before them. Those particular worlds existed by, let's say, 1998, they say our Earth was 13 billion years old. Well, prior to 13 billion years ago, we had another world that we used to rule that existed about 13 billion years before the Earth came to be. That particular world was a much more superior world. It just got old and it needed to redo itself, so it went to sleep to sift out and graft out its imperfections. So the world we are in now, the entire universe is a matrix. Because there's no such thing as space and time. It's all here. But even if you travel, got on a spaceship and travel to the out in the universe, that's still physical. That's called the petty universe, the illusionary universe. The real universe is the inner universe inside of us. So even the ones that say they lifting shit up, that's fake. You can't lift yourself up until the earth is destroyed. It's impossible. You see what I'm saying? If you just look at this logic, that if we got millions of souls, it's impossible to take each soul to lift one by one, especially now in a world where most of the ancient knowledge that went about to lift up those souls to the illusionary part of the matrix is outside of the physical. Most of that art form is dead now. It's less than 1% that even know that on the planet total Earth, like 0 point something. So what does that mean? If there's a knowledge that you're trying to do to lift souls up. Now, the only thing you're doing is you saying these souls, they may not be just dead people that don't know they ass from a hole in the ground because they didn't get a certain amount of knowledge here and stuff like that, no. Yeah. But even the ones that supposedly are on another level, they still trapped. Why are they trapped? Because until the earth makes a metamorphosis, the whole universe makes a metamorphosis, it's just in another state. It might not be the physical state, and they might have broken the bounds of incarnation, which most dead people are doing now, but still yet, it's still contained in a universe that is old and an imperfect universe that has to be destroyed because a new universe has to come out of it. You see what I'm saying? But it has nothing to do with each one behave a certain way and you're going to get to that high level, because guess what? Nobody's on that high level. Nobody. It's impossible. I'll tell you why it's impossible. The Egyptians did one thing that is the least common denominator of all the other people around the world, and that is they found the ultimate thing that is behind all spiritual aspect, and that's alchemy. It is the highest art in the universe. Now, according to alchemy, when the soul finally makes its final transformation, there will be no more universe. We will be gods again in our own universes, in our own new worlds. For the mere fact that you got niggas say they ascending, but we still got 100 million motherfuckers walking down here shitting, pitting, pissing, eating, means that that's bullshit. So all that's fake. All that's a form of religion. It's a better form of religion than Christianity. But still yet, this old outmoded stuff, because if you take the Vedic system, this is interesting about these systems. If you take these systems with all these things on how to raise yourself up, if you study beyond those systems, their original mythology is not even human. Most of that stuff is not even human. If you take the Rig Veda, half of the Rig Veda is done. It's a whole bunch of primal energy entities that has nothing to do with man. Man don't come until the last part of the book. You see what I'm saying? So that means that's only a process and a stage. Now, man is the key. We are the key. But to communicate in the underworld, or the world of the world of the unseen, in the world of the unseen, there's millions of motherfuckers and shit. To get one that even feels like he's not lost, it's just a feeling, because it's still Maya illusion. Because it's not on the physical aspect, don't necessarily mean that these planets. The word for the matrix of what they call Maya is called plane. I don't want to lose people at this thing here, you know. But the point about it here is, this thing is an alchemical text that say, just as gold placed in the mud, we cannot damage our souls. The soul is indestructible and immortal. And it has really nothing to do with human existence other than being trapped in human existence. Now, for the people that don't know the story, because this is an excellent one. This is an excellent one. It's just that in the Kamite story, unfortunately, the text that explained most of this is damaged, and a lot of stuff is lost. And the University of Chicago and other universities are not getting up off the ship. So we may never know, but we don't need to, because it's not like the other stories of some other race. It's all our shit. Now, in this, to understand this particular thing right here, because this is very important, to understand this, the coffin text talked about all this, but it's damaged. In the creation of Ra, Ra come in creating, overthrowing Apep, which is another universe. Apep, Tiamat, Olokun, Echidna, Ra comes in. It's just another cycle coming in, and a later cycle of a primal world that existed before it. So the creation story we get is one of Ra coming in, overthrowing Apep, and Apophis or Apep is just the other primal worlds that existed before that. Now, so you have to go to the ones that survive, and you got to go to the Greek one, explains it. The Babylonian one explains it, the Enuma Elish, with Tiamat, the overthrowing of Tiamat. The Greeks, the overthrowing of the Titans, and later Coptic religion. That's your Gnostic. And they explain these particular things. They explain these particular things. In India, you're overthrowing a Virchra by Indra. Overthrowing a Virchra by Indra. So these stories are in other mythologies. And in the later Egyptian Coptic shit, the priest put the shit right back up in there. Now, in classical Greek mythology, we need to go back beyond the familiar pantheon. That would be Zeus, Ra, Elegba. I mean, going across the board. You see what I'm saying? Indra in India, Elegba in West Africa, Yahweh in Christianity. Most of them is male damn gods. Most of those are male gods in Christianity. Ra in Kemet. And you have to go back. They say go. So remember, the Zeus is not just call that Ra for the people who got a problem with the Greek thing. But this is, remember now, this is all black. So the classical mythology, we need to go back beyond the existing familiar Olympian gods. Now, the world we live in right now is broken up on two types of gods, or two types of existence. The divas, which are the gods that exist in the universe that we live in and have been living in the last 14 million years. The other ones are the Asuras. Those are the pre-creation gods that existed in the primal worlds. So the Asuras, the Netters, the Nephilims, the Giants, the Titans, all of those particular mystical beings existed in the pre-dynastic world. Then you have your Orishas is a newer form. Your Olympian deities, the pantheon of Indra and that whole pantheon and stuff like that. And those are your divas. That's the day side that's dealing with the sun, the created world of formation of the created universe that we have been living in, that we know of. The mystery here is this. They put a cosmic joke on us. It is the classical mythology where the pantheon of Zeus are the following Olympians. Look, we need to go beyond that period to the gods who they overthrew. This is very important, very important. And the sister that needs to hear this the most is walking out of the damn thing. But she got to do this anyway. Because she's been asking about this shit the whole time, and now she's going. What's that?
Yeah, can you go back and give us the author's name on his book you say called Third Out of Hardcover?
Andre Van Lysbeth.
How you spell that?
L-Y-S-B-E-T-H.
Okay.
Yeah, Andre Van, V-A-N, Van Lysbeth. We on? Okay. Now, like I said, they say we need to go beyond the existing pantheon. If there's an existing pantheon of rulers in the universe, that means that their system that's set up can't be the ultimate system because the mere fact that they're going to be on their way out. But it said to the gods, they overthrew. And this is the great mystery of all this shit. And this is the great mystery. If you don't understand nothing, you got to understand this. This is the most profound shit in my 10 years of learning this shit. And that is this. I'm waiting for the damn sister to come back. Well, what the hell? You know. Don't worry about it. Hell, she know what time it is. Okay. You know. Now, we need to go back to the gods that they overthrew. The gods. Come on back, sister, because you got to get this. Because, you know, you say you knew in this. So understand this. You know. And you acting like you talking to spirits that you trying to wrestle. That's the man. You just said some of the most arrogant shit there is. Now come on, man. You mean to tell me that you that high up that you gonna goddamn you releasing some souls? You think I'm supposed to believe that shit, man?
I said communicator. I didn't say release.
Oh goddamn! I talk to souls all goddamn day long. No, you ain't there, because goddamn, I ain't sitting up this motherfucker saying, hey, goddamn, you, these souls are just coming out communicating. Hey, like you lifting up some motherfuckers. Get the fuck out of here, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Come on, man, now. I know this shit, and I won't make that goddamn claim. I'd be like, I can't do nothing for you, man. See, lifting them where? Where they going? Oh, you know where they going? You act like there's some idea of where they going that is this utopian place other than where the fuck they are. I communicate with spirits all day long. Yeah, they're confused, but they're supposed to be confused. Now, it says that we need to go back to the parents that the gods that you worship overthrew some other gods. Get that? You worship some gods that overthrew some other gods. Just so happened that the other gods that the gods overthrew were their parents. There was a group of parents ruling, a group of younger gods came of age and overthrew their parents. Guess who are the goddamn parents? Guess who the parents are?
We are.
We are. That means all that bullshit that the motherfuckers putting in them religious texts are null and void. I'm going to be a goddamn rebel, cutting off heads. Listen to this. We need to go to the gods that they overthrew, their parents, who are known as the Titans. The Titans comes from the word the Titans. Comes from the word Titans. Comes from the word Satans or Shatans. Yeah, they're called the Asuras. They're called the Nephilim. They tell you right in the Bible, the gods that's going to rise up in Revelation are the gods that were slain before the foundation of the earth. Foundation of the earth. They're called the anti-gods. They're called the chaos beings. They got several names for them all over the earth. In Yoruba, they're called the realm of the Olakun. In Voodoo, they're called the realm of the dead. And,